Hey guys, I'm Ryan and I have been hacking things my whole life. If you're new to my channel, I make things in my garage, all types of things. Sometimes I talk a little bit about my personal story and how I got here. And I really have a passion for making things. I have been using robots. I have a plasma cutter, a CNC, 3D printers, and a laser cutter. I use the Glowforge laser cutter. I used an Epilog in school. Today we're gonna be talking about making stamps. So instead of having to print on surfaces, you can actually take your stamp, you can dip it into this archival ink, and then you can go ahead and apply it right to whatever packaging or tags. So we're going to be using regular foam that I got from my craft store. Again, I want to warn you, like I have in other videos, not to use vinyl chloride. Because it can be completely caustic in the fumes, so you watch out for the PVC in some of these foams. So the big task at hand, once you get your graphic, for a stamp, you need to have the negative space. So which means instead of having the letters, you need to have the space around it cut out. And the way that you do that is in Photoshop. So I'm gonna put these steps down below, but in Photoshop, what you wanna do is get your graphic in. I created this in Illustrator. I flip the image because you want the reverse, then select the graphic, select the color. You may need to select similar colors in Photoshop under the select menu. And then what you wanna do is select the inverse, the opposite of that. Then create a new layer and then fill that with black. And then what you have is the area that's going to be etched around your design, the negative space that you're going to subtract with the laser cutter. After that, you're gonna want to glue your foam. I'm using quarter inch foam that I got from my craft store to a piece of wood. This is old flooring that I got from the dump. So someone put really good expensive flooring in a dump. I just cut it up with my circular saw and I'm going to glue this with regular wood glue or Elmer's glue. It really doesn't matter. And then set that in your laser cutter. And then I use the cardboard settings that are new in Glowforge for 1/8 inch cardboard. Except my cut line, I have it set to pretty high in order to cut through this flooring material. So the key is you're gonna want to have your foam glued to the material that you're going to use for your stamp. That's pretty much it for this tutorial, guys. Your key is your settings for etching, finding the right material, PVC, free. Make sure you don't laser cut PVC and you have proper ventilation. I also wanted to mention to you that there is a little stamp making machine that you can buy by Silhouette. That's creates my vector cutter that I make all of my t-shirts with. They have a stamp making kit. I've yet to try out the Mint Studio, but I am definitely going to try this out. The reason why that I was a little bit wanting to do my own stamp using the laser cutter was the stamps are kind of small using this kit. So I'm looking forward to making a video on that. So stay tuned, I'll link that below when that's done. But the most important thing you need to understand is stay safe and then don't go too deep with your engrave. And then make sure that you get a pad. You could roll on the ink, but these pads are great. They're around 10 bucks at your craft store on sale. Whatever you do, make something that connects someone. Love you, take care. I look forward to creating more and more content for you guys. Thanks for your support. I really appreciate it. Bye.